The guidelines, which are a revision of the 2005 regulations, among others, seek to change Uganda's borrowing landscape as well as create an efficient way through which lending institutions gather credit scores to improve loan repayment and accessibility. Speaking during the Third Bank of Uganda Financial Stability Symposium in Kampala, Executive Director for Supervision at BOU disclosed that the amendments have enabled banks to build trust for their clients.
We do work together with the Insurance Regulatory Authority. Now, for example, now that we have licensed an Islamic financial, full-fledged Islamic bank, the Insurance Regulatory Authority already has something called TACA full regulations for Islamic insurance. So there's a bit of, we're kind of syncing our activities in terms of how we do this.
He added that the amendments have also widened the scope of borrowing and reduced risk and cost of lending by banks, which in the past affected the performance of banks as bad loans were written off.
This reduction is largely reflected in the more prudential write-off and provisioning for bad loans that are in the sector. The implications, so this improvement in asset quality is expected to encourage or increase the appetite of financial institutions to continue lending.
The decision by Bank of Uganda to tighten the industry was evident in the Financial Stability Risk Assessment Report issued, which indicated the total special financial institutions loans grew by 7.8% to just over 1 trillion shillings in the year that ended December 2023, higher than 5.4% growth recorded in September 2023.